Max Mashmaster here with Ace Romero, calling the action between Darby Allin and Maxwell Jacob Friedman.
You're talking too soft for me right now. This match is going to be nuts.
I'm trying to conserve my voice because I know what's coming.
Have you ever seen Darby Allin? You don't know what's coming.
I do, because I've called the last two matches he's had here at Limitless. My friends have wrestled him numerous times in Evolve. I know him very, very well.
Okay, well,
I'm trying to keep my voice down because I'm going to lose it before the main event tonight. So when the action picks up, I will pick up myself.
Okay, I digress.
I am flanked here by Ace Romero, and you yourself have a huge match here tonight.
Yeah, man, huge six-man tag, and I mean nuts.
Ooh, Darby Allin able to kick out of that headlock takeover. Before the match, MJF said that he was going to beat Darby Allin with that exact move, the headlock takeover into a pinfall.
Doubtful.
You never know, because he is very crafty. He could just cheat his way into it, right?
I mean, yeah, he loves, definitely loves cheating. He's definitely a guy that likes to pick apart body parts.
Yeah, he loves to use that crowbar submission maneuver on the arm, generally after cheating to injure the arm. And obviously with Stokely Hathaway on the outside, he could play a factor in that later on. Cursing at the fans, a very low maneuver for someone of such a high stature in the world.
Calling them triple chin.
Yeah,
it's hot in here just for me.
It's hot as hell in here. It's mid-March, or just the end of March, and it is hot.
Limitless Wrestling is hot fire tonight.
It absolutely is, because only fools are satisfied, as the name says it. People may be I don't know if they'll be satisfied at the end, but yet, so far they've had an amazing card so far tonight, and we still have five matches to go.
A little handshake by
MJF. I can't believe that. A little handshake just went down there between the two of them.
The punch.
Darby Allin knew exactly what was coming. Able to control the body into a little laying Mahistral cradle on MJF. Passes him by. All the way up. Big Alito right into arm drag. MJF wants none of this, and he's out of there.
Darby Allin's getting it going. Fire up the blades. MJF pissed off, like usual.
Never blue boogers.
He never has a good day.
And when you have so much money that you can have whatever you want, you know, it literally doesn't buy happiness. And he's just smug and pissed all the time about nothing.
Darby Allin taking it in. Attaboy.
He had someone drive him here in a Bentley. Like, why are you wasting your money on things like that?
Oh,
come on. Referee, administer your count. Get him out of here.
MJF thinks he's playing the mind games, but I don't think he really knows who he's messing with.
He does not. Like most people do, they'll watch it, you know, tape or two, understand the moves, how to counter them. MJF hears the name, says, never heard of him. Then he goes back to eating his foie gras.
Foie gras?
That's what he's eating. Fattened goose liver for the layman's here in Maine. But,
oh, here comes Darby. He's done with it.
He's pissed. And now he just blasts MJF. Running for his life, begging, no more. Oh, chop right on the chest.
If I was Stokely Hathaway, I'd say far away from Darby Allin.
Especially before the match, he said, F Darby Allin, which, you know, pissed Darby Allin off. I don't get a read. I don't have conversations with Darby Allin, but I would assume he's kind of a crazy person. Depending, he paints only half of his face.
He shows up in gear and leaves in his gear.
I don't even know if that's gear. Those are just his clothes.
Doesn't talk to anybody. Just comes to work and leaves.
He seems like the type of person that puts headphones on with nothing playing, just so no one will speak to him.
See? Yep. This is not good. This is no bueno.
Yeah, but he's drawing his attention. He knows he has this. His attention, which MJF can come up from behind. I would watch your back. Watch your arm. Just as we suspected.
MJF and Stokely read in the right act. Oh, right in the post. All right, here comes Stokely. Yeah, there he is.
In a bad position. Darby Allin's in a bad position. Oh, using the help of Stokely Hathaway. Darby Allin able to get out of the way.
That's what we call this business stupid. Yes.
Oh, into the, it looks like he's going to throw him into the crowd, but MJF able to escape. Oh, blasted with the forearm. Here he goes.
Oh,
into the chairs.
Oh, no. You don't want a crazed man holding a steel chair.
We got to stand up. We got to get our eyes on this action. Darby Allin with the chair.
Oh,
MJF just getting out of there.
I can't see what's going on. The monitor's out. And there we go. MJF trying to beg and plead, I think.
You see, he's got his hand behind his back. Usually he'll have something concealed back there.
Darby Allin trying to get out of the ring. Referee trying to get MJF back in the ring.
Oh my goodness!
Oh my goodness!
Dudley Hathaway just hit an RKO, but it did no damage to Darby Allin. Would that be called an SHO? Dudley Hathaway Orton?
Exactly. Exactly.
Oh,
oh
no!
RKO is
baited him in. MJF able to get a harder cravat.
Cue the pyro
before he drove the face into the mat.
Well, that was slick, wasn't it?
I like how MJF is very sweaty, unless he got spit on by Darby Allin. He's literally done nothing but run this entire time.
It's hot in here. I'm sweating right now.
Yeah, MJF trying to get his cardio in with all the running he's doing.
You work up a sweat being a bitch boy, you know?
Yeah, exactly. You work up a sweat doing commentary over here in this million-degree building. Arm ringer there, looking maybe to send Darby Allin off into the opposite corner. Oh, crossing the hypotenuse of the ring.
The hypotenuse.
You like that? That's a math term.
I bet you can't even
geometry.
Spell it. Geometry, huh?
Yes. Standing on the fingers of Darby Allin, just stomping down on them.
And letting everybody know, of course, that he's better than them.
We saw Jimmy Jacobs in the match right before this implement the same tactic, just grinding his heel into the knuckles and trying to break those fingers.
Here comes Darby Allin. Catches that boot.
Oh my God, he landed on his feet. Oh, come on. Referee, disqualify him. What's going on here?
Classic bad guy tactics. The old eye poke.
Who do you think that MJF watches to get all of his cheating maneuvers?
Probably you.
I would just slap and punch people. I like the double throat chop. That was my go-to for a dastardly maneuver.
MJF loves that eye poke. That's his go-to.
And he's coming off the ropes, though. Darby Allin able to see out of his good eye. Oh, clapping the ears. Just taking away the equilibrium, causing a little bit of vertigo and into a diving complete shot. One, two. Wasn't able to keep him down.
MJF protesting that was a three count.
The ref's the only person who can overturn that call. He's yelling to the fans as if they can do something. Oh, get off the hair. Come on. And a close fist. Referee's halfway across the ring. Can't even see the action. Darby Allin perched atop the top rope. MJF has got him right where he wants him. Darby, he may be suffering a little bit of equilibrium from that double ear clap. His equilibrium's off, maybe a bit of vertigo. You can see where those fists are landing. All the war paint has been rubbed off on Darby Allin's face.
Uh-oh.
He's going for a bit of a stage dive here.
Uh-oh.
Oh, referee! Oh, Stokely Hathaway pulling the foot.
Darby Allin falling right where he doesn't want to fall.
Absolutely not.
Right in the beanbags.
And maybe take the attention off of his eye and his ears. Fighting off MJF. Back to the top rope.
Oh, my God.
Oh, a little stage dive there. Trust falling right back on him.
A little coffin drop.
Same thing.
What did you call it?
Stage dive.
Oh, stage dive.
Oh, okay.
Didn't know we were at a rock and roll concert.
Brother, you see his face paint? He's a stage diver. Punk.
All right. MJF coming in.
Oh, able to...
Darby caught a little kick right on MJF's knee.
Yeah, Darby was ready.
Front face lock right over that rope.
Darby was ready. MJF was up first, but Darby was just laying in wait. He was ready to strike.
Slings himself in. Oh, dives right on the Stungley Hathaway. Taking out the unequal.
Cardigan and all.
Come on, get back in the ring. Spinning on Stungley Hathaway. That's disgusting. Throw it across the ropes. Oh, double slaps. Head to the chest. Roll it through. Up. Yoshitana. Here it is. One, two. Kicking out. Oh, my goodness.
That was a thing of beauty. I thought those would be three.
Darby Allin trying to shake off every single injury that Maxwell Jacob Freeman has applied. The eyes, the ears, his knee, his groin, everything. He's trying to fight back. Driving all of his weight in, knocking the wind out of MJF for a third time here. Oh, catches two knees right to the spine. Targeting every body part.
No,
dragon suplex right on top of the head. MJF says it's not enough. Going gut wrench up to a bomb. All the way back. Kick to the jaw. He's out. One.
In the ropes.
Oh, referee catches him. Referee catches his feet on the ropes. Oh, able to kick out.
I can't believe Stokely Hathaway is standing up right now.
I know, he caught the elbow right on top of the head from that toe peg.
He's sweating, he's hurt.
No, come on! This is clearly a disqualification. You can't just blast someone with a steel chair in a singles competition here at Limitless Wrestling. That chair is broken. Oh, what's going on here?
Do what you're doing. They got you to the
dead. He's trying to get Darby Allin disqualified. He doesn't want to ruin his win.
Uh-oh. Is he going to do it? MJF's pleading for him to do it.
I kind of hope so.
MJF wants him to do it.
I kind of hope so. Do it, Darby. Take the disqualification. Put him out of here. Oh, referee. Referee takes that chair.
MJF, oh, low blow. No, no.
He's going to beat him with the...
He shoulders it down.
Unbelievable.
What?
Wow, I cannot believe. He won with the headlock takeover.
He's disgusting.
TikTok, I'll make the kids proud. When Becca gets all up in here, we get loud. I heard your dad's rich. You need a new mom. I can keep a secret if you keep mine.
Alec Price gets up with that surprise!
Cover!
He gets up with a surprise! Alec Price! This upset Anthony Greek.
Here is your winner and new Limitless Wrestling World Champion, the prize, Alec Price.
Every bit of the way. Can you imagine the scene with the bell times on? Can you imagine the scene with the pubs around East Boston? The hometown boy done good to himself.
Saturday,
Wrestling Classic in the ring.
Yeah, no better way to start off the six-year anniversary than with a gunfight of a four-way like this.
Absolutely. You want to talk about a revolution? Many revolutions there by Nolo Catano, the House of Glory grad, taking it right there.
Yeah, the Jolene from the village hidden in the concrete might be looking to take flight. But Lee Moriarty had it scouted. Sweep of the legs. Watch the arm.
Watch that arm, and he is very much aware of your body.
Oh, might be thinking joint custody.
Part.
The Absolutely. Joint custody arm bar, but Nolo had it scouted. Caught him with the cross body. Here comes Cashew.
Interesting. Before I get on to Brad Cashew, you want to talk about scouting. A lot of people must have scouted Nolo Catano coming off an excellent six-man tag back in Herman Maine at the beginning of August, making waves on IWTV. That show is available now. So I think a lot of people have had eyes on Nolo Catano. Everybody knows about Lee Moriarty, the recently signed AEW star, getting it on right now with Brad Cashew, who would have lettered in pro wrestling if it was available at BU.
No doubt about it. Picture perfect single leg right there. Lee Moriarty, though, ever proficient with the chain wrestling, regathering the advantage, but now just, whoa!
Say, that gonna be
a split.
A split, absolutely. That is the technical term, folks. Brad Cashew picking up his first victory at our last show, defeating a very game Kevin Koo in a tit-for-tat contest. The one person we have a chance to really talk about right now is the man on the outside of the ring, Alec Price, the Price City OG. Back in the ring now, ready to get it on again, possibly, with Brad Cashew. Heads up! Heads up!
Swinging for the fences!
And this crowd is giving it to Alec Price. I think it's very interesting, the change of heart that this crowd has had for someone.
Alec's bewildered.
I'm gonna let them hear it right now. He doesn't know what to do with it. I was gonna say, this is gonna be a contest right here.
They've been
Catano,
asking for
though.
This.
Wait a second.
Oh, no.
Pay attention, boys. Picture perfect. High impact cross body block off the top rope from Nolo Catano.
Wild altitude on that.
Alec Price, a little change of plans, was supposed to take on Love Dog before Ava Everett and Charles Mason took him out. He had big beef. Gnarls Garvin was not prepared for him and still was able to take care of him at the Vacation Land Cup at the end of August. What is this? What
Corey is this? Special.
What in the world?
Oh, Moriarty.
Don't even tell me that Moriarty slipped the leg. There's only one way to go at this point. Price is trying to figure out what to do. There's a shot. Moriarty feeling it now. Brad Cashew can't get out. This is a precarious position. Catches the leg. Get out of here. Stop it. Ankle lock. Gory special. And a bit of an Indian, just a leg lock.
Taiga style is coursing through his veins right now.
If that is what Taiga style is, beating up three men at once.
That's it.
I'd like Taiga style. That's what I want. Taiga style blood, I suppose.
Nolo Catano, though, laying in the leather on Lee Moriarty. Irish whip.
Yeah, she's going to get him around from belly to back. No. Drives him down into the knee. Coming through. He's looking for a kick. Puts on the brake and shot off. Catano, though. Pele kick to Lee Moriarty.
Got him square in the jaw, but Price takes off.
Right there. Oh, wait a minute. Got the shin up, I thought. Interrupting that kick from Alec Price. Going to catch it. Once again to the back. Ripped up. Catch.
Oh, no. My God.
That spin kick connecting flush with Alec Price. Who will land one flush of his own with a super kick?
With some stank on it. And now Alec Price might be thinking surprise.
Surprise already. This, if he hits it, it's over.
Back position.
Roll through to the schoolboy. All the way up is Alec Price, though. Back up could be a suplex here. Lee Moriarty's got him up. Floats over almost like a Dixie driver. Schoolboy by Price. And mind you, this is not like the Vacation Land Cup. This is not elimination style. First pin is going to win it, Johnny Torres.
No doubt. Lightning fast. Near falls here. Price putting the brakes on.
Very smart. Very smart by Price. Rolling through is Moriarty, who's got the arms.
Oh,
perfect bridge. Kicks out at two does Alec Price.
Dangerous position there. Very close.
Both men catching a breather. Well deserved. And Price, of course, will catch his breath and immediately start talking smack, Johnny Torres.
Here comes Brad Cashew.
Brad Cashew. 3.75 GPA at Boston University.
I think he's got a shellacker.
He's got a 4.0 in wrestling. It's going to be German suplexes. Two of them could be a third on the way.
Absolutely.
Catches him with a third. Beautiful bridge. Extension on that bridge. Making it harder to kick out. Will Dogen says two.
As polished as a collegiate folk style wrestler as you'll find, Brad Cashew. Those bridges, every day you know he does them.
Absolutely. Brad Cashew now once again launches him over. Lance lands on his belly, almost like a moonsault, but with nobody help, that German suplex. Brad Cashew in with a splash to the corner. Cashew with the Northern Lights.
Bridge after.
Another beautiful bridge. It makes it even harder to kick out. Alec Price lucky there. The count of two.
Yeah, right on the tip of those toes with that bridge.
Brad Cashew now with a chance to catch his breath. And we'll also take the time to jaw jack with the fans, but he should probably stay on Alec Price with a slap to the face. I said it earlier, Alec Price with an upset over Gnarls Garvin. Big Beef eliminated first in the four-corner elimination for Vacationland Cup. Caught one of the most vicious death by elbows I've ever seen at the expense of JT Dunn.
But now Alec Price looking to get back on the winner's track.
Once again, catches him with an elbow. Forearm wraps, floats over. Brad Cashew, though, a little worse for the wear. Yeah! Full drop kick by Alec Price.
In the damn face.
The prize will not be denied. Wants to get back onto his winning ways. Alec Price now gets him in the corner.
Measuring Brad Cashew.
Big knee to the face. Brings him off, shooting off the ropes. Coming in hot. Another. That was a pump kick that time from Alec Price.
Watch the face right off him.
Brad Cashew,
one more time.
Looking worse for the wear. Oh, no way. Lance Flash drops the leg, does Alec Price.
That emergency leg lariat.
Center of the ring, almost three. Putting on the brakes with that hand is Will Dojin. Alec Price with a look of disbelief on his face. Lee Moriarty and Nolo Catano nowhere to be found, Johnny Torres. I can't even see them at ringside.
Both picking up the pieces here. Alec having the chance to put this one away.
We've seen this before. We saw what happened to Robert Martyr back at the beginning of the summer. Stomped his guts out.
But here's Lee.
Moriarty back in the ring now. Taking his time, looking for his opponent. Into the buckle. Price stops one. Drops a punch of his own. Could be going up.
What is this?
Double stomp! Right there for Cashew, though. Wait a minute!
No!
Cashew!
What?
Cashew doesn't realize it! No!
Alec Price keeps up a performance like this, we're going to change Yarmouth to the new Prize City.
Absolutely, and you got to believe he was close to being the number one contender tonight. That spot went to Anthony Green, who meets Daniel Garcia in the main event this evening for the Limitless Wrestling Championship. Nolo Catano with the double underhooks with the misbeat. Spins him around. Back up in the fireman's carry. Alec Price has Catano. Going to be struggling out of there. Fights out.
Out the back door.
Gets up Price. What is this?
Might have been thinking grand prize. Nolo puts on the brakes.
Absolutely that grand prize, that flipping DDT. The grand prize from Alec Price. Alec Price.
And Nolo's been here before.
You've seen this again. You know what this is going to be, Johnny Torres.
Sounding the drums of war.
Taking a little too much time, I think, though. Catches him right in the back of the head. Shoots the head. One, two, three. Alec Price kicking off the six-year anniversary with a victory.
Check it out, that on the avenue. A magazine of two is dissing me and dissing you. Yeah.